Hi everyone, welcome to Galand IAS 120 plus. So today's question is from economy. Consider the following statements regarding decreased money supply in an economy. Decreased money supply. So money supply is the topic, and money supply is very hot topic for your preliminary exam. Okay. First statement, it would negatively affect production process and consumer demand in the economy. Second statement, cost of finance will be decreased. Third, there would be disinflation in the economy. Which of the following statements given above is are correct? So this is a three statement question, and you can apply elimination method. So what is money supply? Money supply is nothing but money supplied in the economy. Amount of money available in the economy. That is what money supply. And who dictates this? RBI. RBI is the authority who controls money supply in the economy. How they control it? Using interest rate, open market operation. That is by purchasing and selling government securities. Okay. Deciding on monetary policy rates, sterilization methods, quantitative easing methods, thereby RBI controls money supply in the economy. Why controlling of money supply is very important? If there is excessive money available in the market, if we have excessive money in our hands, what we do? Either we save it or we demand for more goods and services. We buy more goods and services. Okay, that means demand in an economy will increase. If there is excessive money supply, okay, increased money supply, that means demand for goods and services in an economy increases. If demand for goods and services in an economy increases, that means price of goods and services will increases. Okay, whatever commodities, if there is excessive demand, its value, its price will increase. If there is increased demand in an economy, the general price level in an economy will increase. That means inflation increase in an economy. What is inflation? A consistent or persistent increase in the general price level in an economy. That is what? Inflation. Okay. If there is decreased money supply in the economy, exact opposite. Increased demand means increased inflation. If there is decreased money supply in the economy, exact opposite. If money supply in the economy decreased, then the consumers, the parties in an economy will have lesser money to buy, purchase goods and services. That means lesser demand for goods and services. Lesser demand for goods and services means the prices of goods and services will go down. If prices go down, they happen either disinflation or it will go into deflation. Okay, so that's what happens if money supply is not controlled, either going to uncontrolled inflation or disinflation or deflation. So money supply, controlling money supply in an economy is very, very important. So the question is regarding money supply. First statement, it would negatively affect production process and consumer demand in the economy. Of course, that is correct statement. If money supply is decreased, demand for goods and services will decrease. Demand for goods and services will decrease, it affects the production process. Okay. If demand is lesser, then production will go down. So it will affect the production process and consumer demand. So the first statement is correct. Use elimination method. If first statement is correct, then you can eliminate option B. The question is asking for correct statement. So second option B is wrong because that contains only second statement 2. Then second statement, cost of finance will be decreased. Whatever commodity, their supply is reduced. If demand remaining the same, supply is reduced. Okay. What happens? Its prices will go up. Demand remaining the same, supply equals demand, then prices will be same, whatever commodity. Take example of mangoes. There is 10 mangoes and 10 consumers are there to purchase this, then no change in prices. Okay, if there is only 5 mangoes and 10 consumers are there, then demand for mango will increase because there is commodity available in lesser number, but consumers are in more number. So what happens? Then its prices will go up. Okay. If there is 50 mangoes in market and just 10 buyers, commodity is available in excess number, but buyers remaining lower. So what happens? The prices will go down. So that is what basic demand and supply theory. So if whatever commodities, if demand remaining the same, supply go down, decrease money supply. It's same for the money also. For money, demand remaining the same, the supply go down, its value, its cost will increase. What is the cost of money? Normally we talk in terms of interest. That's what cost of finance. Okay. So cost of finance will increase if money supply go down. So the second statement is wrong. Okay. If you know the second statement is wrong, then you can eliminate all options which contains statement 2, that is option D. So the remaining option A and C. Okay. Third statement, there would be disinflation in the economy, of course. If there is decreased money supply in the economy, there may happen disinflation, not inflation. Okay. Maybe that disinflation can go into deflation also. So, third statement is also correct. So, the answer is option C, 1 and 3 only. Then next question is regarding sterilization. What does the term sterilization mean in the context of macroeconomics? Okay, sterilization in the context of macroeconomy. What is sterilization? Here four statements are given. Four options are given. It is a direct shoot question. Less probability for a guessing because no statements are given, just direct four options. You need to pick the correct one. Option A, operation by RBI to neutralize excess money supply due to cheap monetary policy. B, it is an RBI intervention to neutralize increased money supply due to foreign investment inflows. It is process of sterilization of currency notes by banks in the context of coronavirus. It is policy action by RBI to reduce fiscal deficit every year. Actually, sterilization is a process, it's a method adopted by RBI, central bank, to control the inflation in an economy, which happens due to external shocks. External shocks means that mainly due to foreign money inflows. Okay. If there is currency appreciation happening due to foreign money inflows or external shocks, open market operation taken by RBI to control that is what? Sterilization. Okay. If there is excessive money flowing into the country from outside world, okay, that means foreign money inflow into the country, what happens? Money supply in the economy will increase. If money supply increase, what happens? Demand for goods and services increase, thereby inflation will increase. Okay, money supply increase means demand increase, then inflation will increase. To control this inflation, which happened due to this foreign external shocks, that is foreign money inflow, to absorb this excess liquidity, what RBI do? RBI will sell government securities. RBI will give government securities to the market, then purchase this, absorb this excess liquidity. Okay. So that measure taken by RBI to control inflation happening or currency appreciation, if there is excessive foreign money inflow into an economy, the demand for our currency, Indian rupee, will increase. That means increase in the value of currency comparing it with the foreign currencies. So that currency appreciation, to control this currency appreciation, why this currency appreciation need to be controlled? It will affect export. If currency value increase, then it will affect the export. Export will go down. Okay. To control that, measure taken by RBI is known as sterilization. Okay. So here the answer is option B. It is an RBI intervention to neutralize increased money supply due to foreign investment inflows. Okay. So that's all for today. Thank you.